po si Michelangelo Mingorio, national team player po ng billiards. Nag-umpisa po ako ng billiards is 10 years old. Pero ang laro ko nung 8 years old ako is yung pool. Alam mo yung pitya-pitya. Nagsimula ako sa mga kanto-kanto, ganun. Parang laro-laro lang. Pumasok ako ng national team noon. Nung pinasok ako ng taga sa amin, si Tito Luis Barona. Siya ang una nagpapunta sa akin dito noon. Mga 13 years old ako noon, nung nag-training ako dito noon. Ano yun, tawag dito, inaasam-asam ko talaga na makilala rin sa bilyar. Kasi talagang, kasi nung mga panahon ko noon, puro marami rin ako pagsubok pagdating sa bilyar eh. Andiyan yung nag-iikot-ikot ako, nangaharang-harang, ganun. Money-money game. Kasi hindi naman may iwasan yan talaga sa atin dahil maraming ganyan. Siyempre, ang pinakagusto ko ma-achieve yung ito, mag-champion dito sa snooker. Kasi dati mo, hindi ko na rin makuha eh. Siyempre, yun ang talagang pangarap ko, mag-world champion din. At balang araw, alam ko, maaasam ko rin yun.
Welcome back to In Focus. Now, we are about to see an inspiring feature about the former torchbearers of the Philippines for the Southeast Asian Games.
Of course, all of them are now Filipino sporting icons. But during those times when they were assigned to be the torchbearers, most of them were still legends in the making.
Very interesting. On that note, let's go back to those great moments with Bea Escudero.
As the Philippines hosts the 30th biennial meet, who will take the honor of carrying the torch of the games? Let's take a look at some of the torchbearers through the years. In the 11th Southeast Asian Games, Benjamin Silva Neto was given the honor to light the torch of the games. He is a Filipino long-distance runner and is the first Filipino to compete and win in a marathon, which took place in Rojas, Capiz. In 1991, Asia sprint queen Lidia De Vega Mercado lit the flame in the cauldron. Then Taekwondo champion Maria Antoinette Rivera carried the torch and lit the flame in the 23rd Southeast Asian Games in 2005. Who will it be this year? Support our Pinoy athletes in the 30th Southeast Asian Games. We win as one.
It will really be very exciting to know who will be this year's torchbearer. But for right now, it is really very iconic to see once again those images, to say the least. Now, it's time to light up the mood as we move on to the mascots that made the past editions of the SEA Games much more memorable.
Pammy, our mascot for the 2019 Games, will surely do that. Pammy is very cute. And its name entails a heartfelt message because Pammy is short for pamilya or family.
Pammy goes perfectly with the SEA Games' current slogan, "We Win as One." But I'm pretty sure that the Filipino mascot's predecessors were all great as well. Now for more on this, here's Bea Escudero once again.
Hey guys, the 30th Southeast Asian Games won't be complete without the official mascot. Let's learn more of the SEA Games mascots through the years. It was only in 1985 that mascots were introduced in the SEA Games as representations of a country's culture. Kiko Lubuyo, a colorful mountain-dwelling fighting cock, was introduced in 1991. Then in the 23rd Southeast Asian Games in 2005, Gilas was born. Gilas is a Philippine eagle which symbolizes elegance, strength, pride, and the winning spirit of the athletes. Gilas was designed by Filipino sports writer columnist Danny Simon. This year, the official mascot for the 30th Southeast Asian Games is Pammy. Pammy represents every nation, sport, and person coming together at the games. Pammy comes from the Tagalog word pamilya, which means family. Catch the updates of the 30th Southeast Asian Games here. We win as one.
Well, Pammy made a splash on social media when Pammy was revealed, and I am sure that when the SEA Games come rolling along, they'll make a splash once again.
And the SEA Games mascots were all lovely, and they all served their purpose. But I think Pammy is still my favorite.
Oh, there's no argument there. But before we go, you should know that we are almost just 3 weeks away from the official start of the 2019 SEA Games.
And until then, we'll deliver the latest news and most important developments of the week. On behalf of my partner, Paolo Del Rosario, I'm Erica Padilla Carriazo, and this has been In Focus, the 30th Southeast Asian Games Update.